Hey everybody, I'm here today to show you how to fix a broken power cord. And this specific tutorial will be for a power cord that has two prongs. So as you can see right here, this power cord has been, it's just not in good condition at this point right here. And it is definitely dangerous because there are exposed wires. So I'm going to show you a very simple and quick way to fix this. So we are going to have to remove this part right here, the damaged area. But before we do that, we need to make sure that we can distinguish between the two wires. So as you can see right here, there are actually two separate wires, and they are just molded together. But there are two separate wires, and they are insulated completely individually. So completely different sets of insulation. So on this specific power cord, I don't know if the camera can catch it, but if it can focus, you'll see that on this wire right here, there are little ridges on the wire, okay? And on this other wire, on this side, it is completely smooth and flat. So this wire has ridges along the outside of it, and the other side, the other wire, has no ridges. So that will allow me to distinguish between the two. But if the wire that you're working with doesn't have ridges, then you can simply do something like this. So I'm just going to put a piece of tape along the wire that is closest to the camera. So this wire right here on the bottom, I'm just going to put a little piece of tape just like that on that end and on this end, because we will be removing the piece in between. So now even if the wire didn't have ridges, I can see that, oops, I actually did it on the wrong side. I apologize. I'll just put the tape right there. Now if the wire didn't have ridges, I can actually see which wires will match up. Okay, so let's move on. I'm going to use a simple wire cutter, just like this, well, a set of wire strippers right here, and I'm going to cut off the affected area, so the damaged area. I'm just gonna snip it right there, and snip it right there. Okay, so I have actually cut off the damaged area, and the goal is going to be to splice these pieces together. So first we are going to separate the wires. Just as you can see, there are two separate wires, just like that. Separate the wires on both ends, and usually you can just do this with your fingers. Then we are going to strip each of these four wires. So the tape obviously fell off, but I can distinguish which wires go with which because of the ridges on the wire. But if your wire does not have any distinguishing features, then you should definitely either use a marker or some tape and make sure that the tape stays on. So we're gonna strip these four wires down, and I'm just going to use my pair of wire strippers right here. I'm gonna strip about an inch to an inch and a half off of each of these. So I'm just gonna pull that off just like that. As you can see, I've stripped it, and I'm gonna do the same thing with the other three wires. Alright, now that I have stripped down the four wires right here, I'm just going to twist them, because if you can take a look and see, there are many fine wires within each. So I want to manipulate them and sort of twist them around and make them one, so that when I bend the wires and so forth, I'm not bending many small and thin wires. I am bending just one piece of wire for the most part. So now that we have stripped them down and twisted them together, we are going to match up the wires. So once again, I have the ridges on the wire, so I can see that this wire right here, and I hope the camera can catch this, this wire has ridges on it right here, this one, and on this side, this wire right here has ridges on it. So once you have matched up the wires, whether it is a distinguishing feature like the ridges or tape or a marker mark that you made, you are going to simply twist them together. So I'm going to take these two wires right here, and I'm going to twist them together just like that, and do a good job. This way you won't have to worry about them coming apart or anything like that. Now, as you can see, I have twisted them together. The next step is to take some electrical tape and wrap the electrical tape around the wires. This is to keep the wires together and protect them. And some people choose to use wire connectors to keep the wires together, or even solder them together. But for this tutorial, I'm doing it in a very simple and easy way with electrical tape, just like that. Just wrap it around a few times, try and make it look nice and so forth. Okay, now that those wires have been twisted together, I'm gonna do the exact same thing with these two wires right here. So we're gonna twist them together, and once again, I know that they match up because these two wires were the ones that did not have the ridges on the cord. They were the ones that were smooth. So I'm just gonna wrap some electrical tape around them as well. All right, and the last and final step is to take some electrical tape and wrap it around both of the wires. And I like to wrap it around the entire area that I was working on. So from where I split the wires over here to where I split the wires over there. So I'm just gonna do that very quickly. And there you have it. I have repaired this broken power cord, and once again, this power cord was one that has two prongs. So if you have a broken power cord and you want to fix it, just follow the steps in this tutorial and you'll be good to go. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.